Greetings, friends. The following is from an article I came across the other day, which was an answer for a question asked. How can I explain to my very special friend, Tiffany, so she may understand that her world can be different and filled with joy? The article also explains very well some of the information I received during several of my personal meditations, and has been a big part of our project, of which, in the past, with great difficulty, due to my lack of communication skills, I have attempted to explain or share this information with a small circle of associates, that the structure of this three-dimensional universe is based on the number three, the Trinity, meaning structurally, one cannot exist without the other two. Math, magnetics, and mass. Here we will briefly attempt to show you how just by changing your perspective, you can affect in a very positive way all those around you. Now, with the help of this article, which was apparently inspired by the great Nikola Tesla, and a few of my personal alterations, I will share it with you. In vortex math, or what I call the real or universal math, everything adds to 3, 6 and 9. Polarize everything. 1, 2, 4, 5, 7 and 8. Describe the physical world. Therefore, 3, 6 and 9 do not reflect the physical, but govern the physical world at the quantum level. This is most easily understood by examining sound, where different sounds exist at different frequencies, or vibrations, and that all things living are vibrational. Vibrational frequency is the key to understanding the universe. Try and see beyond three-dimensional thinking, rather than involving yourself on the lower levels through world conflicts propagated by fear, television, or television, and all the other fear propaganda designed to keep you scared and ready to take up arms, sitting in a panicked state waiting, thinking of nothing but the worst possible outcomes. Everything is energy. Everything we can see, hear, touch, taste and smell is made of different wavelengths, vibrating at different frequencies. Our brain is like a translator that has the ability to interpret these frequencies, transforming what we perceive into our physical reality. So, we interpret an energy cluster as a chair, a tree, another person, etc. We perceive them as physical or solid, but break them down to their smallest particles, and they're all just energy. Of course, there are non-physical energies as well. For example, our thoughts, which are just different vibrations. Every time you think a thought, you send out that thought's specific vibration. If a thought makes you feel good, if it's a positive thought, it is vibrating at a high frequency. If a thought makes you feel bad, if it's a negative thought, it's vibrating at a lower frequency. So, I hate you has a much lower frequency than I love you. The more focus you give to a thought, the more thoughts of the same vibration will join it. This is the law of attraction in action. Like attracts like. As the vibration grows, it becomes stronger, more stable, more able to attract other equal frequencies. The more attention you pay to a subject, the easier it becomes to think about it, and the more evidence you see in your world supporting those thoughts. If you think the world is a terrible place, and spend a lot of time watching negative news, looking for horrible and sad stories in the paper, and spending hours talking to others about how the world is going downhill, More stories supporting this worldview will literally find you. Whenever you meet someone who thinks the world is a wonderful place, they're probably going to annoy you. The energy of their thoughts is completely foreign to you. Cheers.